what is going on? So you have a sampler with no effects. What can you do to solve that problem? Well, in this video, we're going to look at creating digital delay from scratch, which is a low, no-cost DIY approach to creating effects with your vintage sampler or a modern sampler or any sampler. But first, I'd like to invite you to like, share, and subscribe to our sampler channel. And with that, let's get to it. All right, so what is delay? Delay, also known as echo, is a repetition of your source sound occurring later in time. Now, this can repeat itself over and over again, or can be just an immediate repetition. And ideally, what you want is the sound to fall off in amplitude or volume over time. So what tools do we have with a sampler that can recreate the sensation of delay? And it just so happens that we have everything we need on most samplers to do this. The first tool we'll need is a looping function, and the second we'll need is an amplitude envelope. Let's start off with the Akai S612, a very basic sampler, to recreate some delay out of a snare drum. So the first thing we'll start with is looping the snare drum so that it repeats. Not bad, eh? Pretty decent. Let's try the same thing on the Roland S760. And I'll apologize for the screen. I'm not sure why it's jittering, but... Alright, so we've extended the release time of the envelope in both examples to give us a trailing decay of the looping snare, recreating digital delay. This, in essence, gives you far more control because you can create different types of delay, you can add filters, you can do much more before you actually commit to buying a dedicated effects unit or buying a sampler with effects in it. So if you're in a situation where you're using a vintage sampler and you're craving for some effects, I would recommend exploiting every single technique you can to create all types of effects with the tools you have. This will make you much better at creating sounds as well as creating music, because the more you understand about how to get what you need, the less you will need to depend on external processors to get the sound you want. So when the time actually comes for you to expand your studio, you'll be more than ready to take your music to the next level. Anyway, thank you for watching. If you liked and learned something today, subscribe to us here on YouTube. I will catch you on the next one. In the meantime, take care of yourself. Peace.